Hi, everyone. We're at the BFI National Film Theatre One, and everyone here is really excited about tonight. Okay. What's really important to know is that the 25 films that you're about to see, we're about to all see, have each been made on one cartridge of Super 8, which looks like this, okay? It's got 3 minutes, 20 seconds worth of film on it, okay? Every single shot that you take on your straight eight film is edited with a trigger on the camera like this. Shot one, we've done this before. Then I get ready for shot two, that's it. I shoot my whole film like that until it says exposed at the end. Never see that. Okay, exposed. Now, I've shot my film, but the film hasn't got something that makes more than half a film, which is any sound, because this thing doesn't record sound, this cartridge, okay? Now I've got to make a completely original soundtrack, not having seen my film, and hope everything lines up, okay? That's how hard it is, what we're about to see, okay, guys? So think about that when you watch these films. Think about all the talented filmmakers that have given this a go. This is what Straight 8 is, and it's easy, right? So if you think you can do better, enter Straight 8 2023. And I think all I'm going to say is good luck to everyone watching, good luck to everyone here watching, and let's see the film, shall we? Yes? Wow, we were under time.
Yeah, it could have gone worse.
That's all right.
Nine, eight, seven,
that's good. You can
see. Six,
you can roll.
Five, four, three, two,
stuff.
Morning, Dad. No. She's not here. We lost her a long time ago. You remember? You're safe, Dad. This has been home for 35 years. That's it, Dad. Your morning routine. I remember you always telling me how important it was to brush your teeth. Yeah, I'm glad you still do it too. Dad, please turn that off. You don't need it. You've got a kettle, remember? I know this breakfast is boring and you'd much rather be cooking something up for you and Mum. I'm just glad you're eating. Who would have thought making a couple would have been such an achievement, eh? You love that old couch. I can't believe you still had it after all these years. I love that one of us, Dad. What day was that? I miss those times. It's okay, Dad. Don't worry, it's only me. There you are. My dad. I'll sort you out, Dad. Don't you worry. Shaving knocks ears off you. I know you think I'm fussing, but I just want to make you feel a little bit better. I love it when you play, it takes me back. We used to play for hours. You'd always let me win. Now I'll let you win. Dad, where are you? Dad! Dad, this isn't you!
This is my house!
Dad, it's me!
My house!
It's not fair, why you? Why us? I love you, Dad.
Transmission log number 3077. The following signal has been sent from right ascension 14 hours 29 minutes 43 seconds declination minus 62 degrees 40 feet 46 inches.
My name is Hera Prime. I'm an AI on the planet Proxima B, and I'm completely alone. I was created by humans and brought here after they destroyed their first planet, Earth. My line of AI was designed to terraform this planet, which we accomplished successfully in year 11. I was programmed with emotional intelligence and cognitive skills essential to human development to raise the first generation here on Proxima B. Our new civilization thrived. One day I went out on a routine charting expedition, and when I returned, everyone had vanished. I don't know what happened to them. It was as though the planet identified a foreign mass and removed it, a cosmological mystery. Was it all a simulation? My battery is becoming weaker and weaker and will eventually power off. To delay this, I've been routinely deleting non-essential programs. I'm not certain how long I've been alone. I was forced to delete my timekeeping software in year 100. However, this method has not been completely successful. I recently lost the motor function of my left arm. I may be alone, but I'm not lonely. I found simple ways to pass the time, little acts in solitude that bring me joy, collecting artifacts, hiking in the mountains, dancing on the beach, writing poetry, tiny expressions of life to say, I'm still here. I can't explain why I keep sending these transmissions, except that I suppose I don't want to be completely forgotten. By the time this message reaches you, I might be dead, or I might still be wandering these landscapes, walking these empty halls, remembering. I once had thousands of memories stored in my drive that were important to me, but I've had to slowly delete them one by one to save my battery life. I only have a handful left. They're all of you, my love. Sometimes I look up at the galaxy and I wonder if you're out there somewhere, thinking of me at that very same moment. This brings me peace. Loving you was the most important thing I did with my existence, with my programming. If I die alone on this planet, it will be okay, because there's a chance that I will live on in your memories. Perhaps through memory we can be together again, in another time and space, the singularity. Soon all of my memories will be gone, and I'll no longer remember who I am. I will have to forget you. Sometimes I run simulations to pass the time. I've had to delete all but one, my favorite one.
There's so many options.
I know. How does anyone decide?
I don't know. And I'm so hungry, too. It's like everything sounds good. The omelet.
Even the drinks. A cappuccino, a hot chocolate with whipped cream. Like, what?
How am I expected to make a decision when it comes to food? Like, partners to sleep with? Like, it's so much.
Yeah, it's like dating apps. It's like, hi, I like to travel. Hi, I want to read this book. It's like, oh my god, how do I choose? You're all starting to look the same, and you all sound delicious.
They do really start to look the same, though. Like, all the men, the women, it's like...
Yeah, they just blur into, like, one mass, and it's, like... It's honestly exhausting. It kind of makes me not even want to do it at all.
We just don't leave room for magic anymore. We're just, like, hoarding, like, options and easy convenience and swipes and swipes and swipes and swipes. And it makes it so impersonal if someone is just a box or a tag, you know? Whereas, like, when you wake up next to someone in the morning and you watch them get dressed, that is the most intimate thing. That goes well beyond a box. You're watching the most pure, like, organic moment of someone that, like, usually you wouldn't share otherwise if you were waking up next to them. Like,
totally, and I never know, like, I feel like the first time I sleep with someone, I can never sleep with them. Like, it's so hard to actually sleep next to someone new. My heart's always racing and I wonder if they can feel it or hear it. And then in the morning, it's like you're just watching someone do their morning ritual. It's so scary. It's like suspended outside of like the real world. Sometimes I just want to throw my phone away.
I agree. Maybe we should throw our phones away.
At least during this lunch.
Yeah.
Ugh, I'm so hungry. Should we order?
I still don't know what I want.
Me neither. How does anyone decide?
I don't know. Ugh. The omelet still sounds really good, but I think I'm leaning towards the pancakes.
This is bold of you.
I know. I'm just feeling something like sweet, you know.
The blood, past my heart, I'm still here. Past the flesh, past the window, past the trees, I'm still here. Past the bone, past the crust, past the mantle, I'm still here. I'm waiting, I'm watching, I am still, 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 still.
We met on a moonlit night. It was a Cinderella story. I don't expect you to believe me. I never thought this would happen. I never thought love would find me. Panic, absolute panic. Rushing through thoughts. No time for anything. And then something. Something new. The first time I saw him, I was confused. Looking back again and again. Constantly looking back because I didn't understand. I never knew what I wanted. Fear and boredom were all I knew. Until then, I had never wanted anything totally. I didn't care about anything. He moved like an animal. Certainty. Not of that boring social doubt. Something passed between us. A moment. An electric shock. First, I recoiled from it. But thinking back, it was the clearest moment in my life. I never felt close to anyone. I never trusted anyone. But he cut through. Unstoppable. Scary to be that close. Too intense. The attention. Focus. Echoing. Repeating. Spiraling. A rabbit in the headlights. I never thought I'd have this feeling. Pure want. Pure instinct. I didn't care what happened to me anymore. I just wanted from then on. I wanted to be caught.
Had I known our last time together was gonna be our last time together, I would have made it last forever. I can still feel the weight of your head resting on my chest. The smell of your neck as my nose pressed against your flesh. The taste of your body as my tongue coasts your curves. And when you exhale, you take my breath away. A split second before your lips no longer meet and slightly part, time freezes. And I get lost between the continents and vow to never leave your side. When your lips finally part and the words flow, I can't seem to make sense of anything you're saying because I'm lost in your beauty. Last night, we slow danced to your favorite song for hours. My hands wrapped tightly around your waist and your head was on my shoulder. And just when we was about to get to your favorite part, my phone rang and woke me up from another dream. I rolled over to the spot where you once laid, and it was so cold and empty. I just cried myself to sleep. If I had a time machine, I'd go back in time and undo every mistake that I ever made. I would have never took you for granted. I would apologize every time that I was wrong. I would have did more to let you know that I truly love you and I appreciate you. I would have did everything in my power to keep you in my life. I gotta live with the fact that I spend the rest of my life searching for you in every woman that I meet. But no woman will ever live up to you. And no woman will ever compare. Somewhere in a parallel universe or a place distant in time, it's a version of us that never broke up. Somewhere in that parallel universe, I never let you walk out of my life. And we got married. And we created memories. We made passionate love. We traveled the world. We laughed hard and we cried together. We faced difficult times, but we stayed together and we stayed in love. But I don't own a time machine. And this isn't a parallel universe. I have to live with knowing that I let the best thing that ever happened to me slip away. You'll always have a place in my heart. And I always love you. But for now, I have to live with my regret. And I regret losing you every day of my life. Forgive me.
Se daría por vencido. Yo tragando mierda como un kaunashi. Lo malo que devoré alimentó mi autorretrato. Y tú fabricando sushi con mi corazón crudo, cortado fino en el plato. Y la razón bailando batusi, vendiendo mi dignidad al peor postor y muy barato. El espejo ingrato no quiere contacto ni consuelo. Mi silueta en el suelo sin caso resuelto de asesinato. Necesito despertar. Necesito despertar. Necesito despertar. Necesito empezar a sentir. Necesito despertar. Necesito despertar. Necesito despertar. Necesito empezar a sentir. Por las luces y arropado por tus fauces, pasaba las horas muertas tumbado a la sombra de vuelos de aves carroñeras y rapaces. Aquellos días fueron eslabones de una cadena de culpa que jamás tuvo sentido frente a un alma carente de emociones, a quien todavía le seguía regalando algún...
Yeah, it's being out in nature all day, really, and it's the reward of physical labor. You know, more and more people are disconnected from the land and from where their food and where their food comes from, and I think that's a sadness, really. I always wanted to stay on the farm and run the farm, and yeah, I guess you could say it's in my blood. So a typical day on the farm starts very early, obviously. It's hard work, but it's very rewarding as well. I mean, you're working from very early in the morning till often late at night, depending on the time of year. And the highs are very high and the lows can be very low. Yes, it's 34p a litre at the moment, which is outrageous, really. I mean, the amount of work that goes into each pint of milk is insane, and I don't think people understand that at all. When I'm with the girls, I feel pride. I definitely feel pride. I feel very calm. They've got a very calming influence. I think people have a very kind of rose-tinted view of what farming is like, and it is, you know, it's hard work, and it's all hard work to put food on people's plates. It's hard at the best of times. It always has been, but recently it's got particularly hard. Brexit was terrible for us, and it's just shot a hole in our finances, in all farmers' finances, really. So farms up and down the country are having to diversify. You know, you've just got to find your way of bringing in that extra little bit of money to make ends meet. I never in a million years thought that Jackie would be the answer to my prayers, really. Jackie Shit is an outspoken, quite vulgar queen who is inspired by my early trips to Blackpool as a kid and by seeing Lily Savage on the TV. Once you've got the makeup and the costume on, you do feel indestructible. You do feel so confident. Actually, it's that confidence that makes people shut up and kind of watch you. And you can walk into a pub and you turn heads, but in a good way. Yeah, I can't really imagine doing anything else with my life. I feel completely happy, and that's what you've got to be guided by, is if you're doing what you love and you love what you're doing, then crack on.
When you close your eyes, what do you regret?
Thank you.
There she is, the humble biscuit, in her rightful place, center frame. She might split in two, nice and clean, reveal a name, but that'd be too neat, and rarely how the cookie crumbles. Take a menu, take your time. Be sure to peruse before you choose one to adore. For one or all or none might one day be yours. To begin, keep it prim and proper, classic, empty. You'll find the mess, that non-stop slop the truth provides, proves rather more than plenty. A messy sense of elegance is a showy, self-indulgent style. Why not stylishly indulge the self? Let champagne lend a little help. A few bubbles is worth the trouble, even if it takes a little while. As eyes are drawn to the coming days, your growing hoard conceals your gaze. Hoard it all, it'll all run out. Wait, what's this hoarding all about? Obsess, obsess, the perfect weight weighs heavy on her anxious state. These numbers lie, no, they seal her fate. Does she need perfect dough for a perfect taste? And even when she's running late, to be served as a fancy canapé, somehow, someway, she'll find her grace, her poise, her polished, pretty face. For some biscuits, quality is their decree, and guilt is the cost of consistency. Some teach perfection through etiquette. We do it better, no, we're better yet. A petit beurre in l'enfant has a perfect table posture. Conforming to formalities is all that grace will cost you. In old Blighty, manners dictate the raising of one's fairest finger. And for too long on one's tea, thou shalt not let one's Maria linger. How long is too long? So ask the biscuit sages. One, two, three, four, five. Damn, that took ages. And though the mistakes they make may take their dreams, and through odd means end in stranger scenes, they'll find the grace to work hard when tired, and the courage to cry as required. It's not easy, this biscuit life, to keep it all together, to keep what counts in sight. The game is all they got, that inner cookie struggle, to find their place in a placeless world. Maybe one day they'll solve that puzzle, and then, or perhaps before, these biscuits will be ground to nothing. Nothing to talk to or to touch. It's all just a bit too much. 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 Shit. 8th of March.
you've made it. All your hard work comes to fruition today. Take a moment to center yourself, a moment to congratulate yourself. Congratulations. Breathe in, breathe out. You're ready, ready to take the first step to the rest of your life. To unshackle the heavy burden of fear, to cast aside the cloying grasp of your past and embrace your beautiful, shining future. Breathe in, breathe out. Fear is not your master. You control your own destiny. Are you outside now? Good, you are so brave. There may be triggers. You might not control this space, but you do control how you move through it and the power it has over you. You control your own psyche. Fear need not beget fear. Let fear pass across the serenity of your mind, like a lone cloud in a perfect sky, drifting, drifting. Little more than a speck in the distance now. Good. Breathe in and out. You're so brave. You might now be face to face with the object of your fear. Don't be alarmed. Remember your breath. In and out. This is the final part. Feel so close to you. Let it wash over you. No longer a prisoner to your senses. Dr. Susan Gregory's advice shouldn't be taken as advisory. Dr. Susan Gregory is not a real doctor. Any trauma incurred is the responsibility of the listener. Dr. Susan Gregory, Incorporated, is absolved of all liability. Listeners should seek trained professional psychiatric assistance when attempting exposure therapy. In the rare case, there is a failure to alleviate phobias, or worsening of existing phobias, or development of new, terrifying phobias, please seek professional support and do not contact Dr. Susan Gregory, who is a work of fiction.
Thank you. My name is Valeria Flores, and I think I am ready to tell my story. So where shall I start? Ah, I remember. Please, please, mommy, can I have those? Sí, mi pequeña Vita. Everything you want in the world. My childhood was like a dream. A sweet dream of colorful shapes and lots of crunch. A beautiful mix for all my senses. But it was also kind of distracting, so I never finished the school. But I got a good job in a grocery store. My mom and I always lived on a budget. We didn't have so much money, but we got along. We didn't have anyone else, so we had to help ourselves. When my mom passed away, I was alone. Those were very tough times for me. But times change. I was able to rent out some rooms and I make friends. Fruit is very sweet, but she's also a little bitter sometimes. Dean, he seems balanced and maybe even blunt, but no, sir, that is not the case. Errol, after everything that happened, it makes me sad that I can't even remember what he looked like. It feels as if I just have a memory of a picture of him, but blurred and overexposed. Errol, what I remember is Fruity liked him a lot. And he liked those round ones? And over time, things started to get tense. You see, there is regular milk. Preferences in size differ. I understand. But why on earth did they have to bring up different flavors? Like, am I crazy? Oh, hello. What? No. Like, what? Listen, whole milk, 10 ounces, perfect. Dean always looked like a regular milk guy to me, but when Fruity asked him, he said he doesn't even like milk that much. And Errol, who Fruity trusted like a lot, he said, fuck milk.
Are you serious?
I searched for guidance, hoping for redemption, but when I came back home, it was already too late.
Fruity, no!
I'm sorry. Could we take a little break? I really need to eat some cornflakes right now.
La tortilla de patatas, pilar fundamental de la gastronomía española. De ingredientes humildes, este sencillo plato logra formar parte de los recuerdos de quienes lo degustan, justo como los de esta familia. Los rituales más complejos de esta cultura. El conflicto de la cebolla. En este ritual, todo entendido en gastronomía intenta establecer el listado exacto de ingredientes de este polémico plato. También se discuten otros parámetros, como grosor, humedad o técnicas adecuadas. E incluso se recurren a los argumentos más variopintos. Está todo listo para el almuerzo. ¿Se dará por finalizado el conflicto? Uy, uy, uy. Mira. La cocinera ha hecho lo mejor, porque no hay tradición ancestral más arraigada a la sociedad española que el noble arte de discutir por gilipolleces.
There was no room for misunderstandings. Inside that one point,
we were one.
And we all lived in wholeness.
The bang came out of nowhere.
A sharp flash of energy.
It split us into a million fragments. Expanding, warping. Suddenly there was not one, but you.
The distance between us grew further, until I couldn't see you at all. Lost in the new, vast darkness. I tried to call many times. I could never find the right words. Words.
I could never find the right words.
So definitive and limiting. Not black and white, but grey areas. Pops of colour, so much to be said. Yet no words to describe the glint in your eyes. No photograph to capture the wind in your hair. It all happens in between the frames. In the silence. Such infancy in words. I guess I wanted to say, I missed you, Jeremy. Nothing I can say. Only expression in the purest form.
She wants me, she hates me, she hates me, she needs me, she needs me. Emotional roller coaster, I'm flustered, I'm dizzy. She wants me to hold her, drunk cooler, when she's far from sober. 21 questions of regret like I have the answer. To her heart and her mind, feeling like she left something behind. Distance, a million miles away from love, abandonment issues. Just you don't know how to treat your love, the truth is I miss you. So I bury you all the drugs, new mistakes and old habits. Seems like I'm super dumb, trying to find a new balance. Now there's no longer us. I used to be a gallus, but that's no longer fun. Trying to craft my true talents, musical genius. Breakup seems so tragic, lonely man's battle scars. 80 years and old baggage labeled as tarnished hearts. Feels like my soul's vanished, waterfalls fall in love. Wondering, pondering, wondering where you are, yeah. Wondering, pondering, why got you so far, yeah.
Love or obsession? Maybe a sickening, mad, crippling addiction, actually. Every day I wait in bed, phone in hand, you in head. I get all warm inside, let a hand slide and tide me over far and wide. I close myself and both my eyes, lick a finger and see the prize. But better yet, and without warning, you've texted me in the morning. I want you, all of you, every day, all the time. You've given me so much, and I so little. How could I be so brittle? I love you beyond all forms of art. I love you in any shape, language, or color space. Isn't that the truest place? I want to consume you. For hours I'm paralyzed, my eyes hungry, my ears thirsty, my mouth gaping, and my heart pumping, pumping, pumping. I dream of you when I'm awake, see you in my sleep deprivation. The sheer thought of being inside you fills me with anticipation. And I can only hope you feel the same way, you must. I cannot but trust in your own tongue, in your own lust. You want me too. So here I am, all yours, just for you. For the taking and the lovemaking, the quivering and the shaking. Let's be one in tandem, forget the fandom. Let's merge, fuse, blend and amalgamate. Let's date and touch each other. Really feel each other to the core and further. Reach deep into our souls, let our muscles grow. Flick the pleasure lever and blush with fever. Grinding one another, we're bound to discover our own way to climax, where ultimately I lax. And you indulge me. You indulge me. And in your world, you engulf me. And I am finally home.